Here we are with Luna and Caper's puppies. They're 6 weeks old. They're double doodles. All of them are the same color, apricot, shades of apricot. What can I say? The coats are not as curly as Mom. Here's Mom. Luna. Hi. Luna's getting a haircut later. She's quite curly. Oh, she wants to be held. Okay. Here's Luna. Luna's about 40 pounds. And Caper's a little bit smaller, 36, 37, I think. So, I have my helper here, Ella. Say hi, Ella.
Hey.
She's going to hold up each puppy and I'll say who they are and, a little bit about their personalities that I've seen. Okay, so let's start. Well, let's start with Pink, which is Mandy. We have 2 girls and 6 boys. Of course, I think it's the one on her back or this one here. No, it's this one here. There we go. So Mandy has a lot of white on her. She's got quite pretty. She's got a black nose that's filling into black. So she'll have dark brown eyes. Again, the coats are more like Caper's. They're not really tight curl. Mandy has shown a little bit of shyness, but I think she's coming through that. So we're just going to continue to work with her and make her comfortable, but she's shown a little bit of just a little bit of reserve, not the first one to jump in, unlike her sister Reese, who is probably the most outgoing of all these puppies. Her coat is what we call apricot. It may fade, but I don't think it will. Usually if it's going to fade, we see lighter areas around the eye at this age, but we're not seeing that, so she may stay darker like Daddy Caper. Oh, Ella's getting bit. Okay, so that's Mandy, pink collar. So just pick up the next one and we'll see. So light green is Frankie. Hi, Frankie. So he's got a brown nose and he's gonna have hazel eyes. And he's quite light in color. And as you can see, remember I just mentioned the lightness around the eye? He's kind of got a little bit of that going on. It's called a halo. So he's probably going to get a little lighter over time. He'll be more of a cream. He appears to be a little bit on the smaller side for this litter. I wouldn't expect him to be less than 30 pounds, but he might be one of the smaller ones. Personality-wise, middle of the road, there's nothing obvious about him. He seems confident enough. He plays with the other pups. He likes to be held. You can see he likes Ella a lot. I know, you're really cute. So that is Frankie in the light green collar, or lime green, I guess we can call it as well. Okay, so Frankie's done.
Dark green
is Ranger. The Ranger looks very similar to Mandy in that he has a lot of white on him. He's got a black nose, so he's going to have darker eyes. And again, a little bit, I don't know that he's going to get much lighter. Doesn't have the halo thing going on. So he'll be a light apricot and he'll retain his white spots. Personality-wise, really middle of the road, gets along with everybody. Again, very comfortable being held. Nothing that I would be concerned about. He would be a nice little pup for a family, I think. He seems confident enough to be with kids. Ella is 12, but her little sister, what's Livy, 8?
9.
Livy comes to visit sometimes too, and she goes in there and they'll play with her. So they're doing well. So that is Ranger in the dark green collar. Okay. Pick up the one that's biting you.
Yeah.
So this is the darkest one. What color? Yellow?
Yellow.
Yellow is Jules. He is the darkest of them. I wouldn't call him red. He's like a dark apricot. He's probably going to fade a little bit. Most of them do. But he doesn't have the halo effect. So him and Mandy might keep their darker colors. He also has shown a little bit of shyness, but he seems to be coming through that. He was one of those puppies, we call them watcher puppies. He would let the other puppies dive into new experiences before he would join in. That's not a bad thing, but sometimes they do better in a house with another dog who's confident. They don't necessarily want to be the lead. They'll show some submission. I probably wouldn't place him with small children only because if there's a little bit of shyness there, little kids make a lot of noise, a lot of unpredictable movements, and that could be a scary thing for a dog. So I would prefer to place him with a family that's got older kids, like perhaps Ella's age or even Livy's age, 9 or 10. Or even not even have any in the house. I guess he'd be fine in a house with adults, but he would do well with another dog. So that was Jules. Hey, Jules. A few days ago, if we did that, he wouldn't make eye contact with me, which is why I say he's a little bit on the submissive side. Just trying to find light blue. So this is Freddie. Freddie, I think, is the biggest. He has a brown nose, so he will have hazel eyes. I believe he has a home already. Somebody's quite interested in him. So he has white paws and white strip on his head. I would say he's very comfortable. He has always been one of the ones to be more outgoing, trying to get your eye contact, things like that. So his temperament is really quite nice. Luna just got caught on the crate. He's pretty solid, so I think he is going to be probably about 40 pounds like mom, or even bigger. So like I said, I think he has a home already anyway, but that is Freddie. And so we haven't done red yet.
Did we do it?
No. Okay, purple is Reese. Now Reese is the smaller female. She has a brown nose. She has no white on her. She's kind of the boss of the pack. Sometimes the smaller ones just take on the attitude of being the boss lady, let's call her. So again, I think she has a home. We're probably going to look at keeping her as a potential breeder. Her coat is straighter and she's a bit smaller than Mandy. Otherwise, nothing special to say. Oh, can you watch your hand? I can't see. There we go. The fact that she has a brown nose is kind of a nice thing for breeding purposes, because we can actually make chocolates if we breed her to the right males. So, okay, so that was Reese. We still need to do Red, which is Kit. He's right by your ankle. So Kit looks very similar to Mandy and one of the other ones with the white on his face. His coloring is going to be a light apricot. Personality-wise, he's kind of middle of the road. He just fits in with the pack. He's not the boss boy, but he's not the most submissive either. He seems to be well socialized and quite comfortable being held like this. So that is Kit. His coat is the same as the others. Their coats are all fairly wavy, I'm going to call them. They're not going to be tight like mom's. But yeah, that is Kit. And then the next one that we haven't done is Orange Mason. I think that's the last one.
Yeah.
So, Mason is like Reese in that he has a brown nose. Again, not a big deal for anybody that's adopting. They don't usually care. But from a breeding perspective, there's a genetic there. That means he can make chocolate babies. But I don't need any boys right now. But you can see his eyes are, if he stops moving, he's got, Ella's getting bit. He's got hazel eyes. So he... Pardon?
Mohawk dude.
Oh, that's right. We call him the Mohawk dude. You can kind of see he's got a little cowlick right here. Goes right down the middle of his face. So that won't show up later when he's groomed properly. But right now, it's just a cowlick. This eye here looks very blue right now. Which will change to more of a hazel green. What can I say about him? Mason, this is orange?
Yep.
Yeah. Mason, he's very similar to most of the other boys. I don't have any standouts here. He just kind of goes with the flow, gets along, they play. Are you going to make eye contact with me, buddy? He's a little bit shy, this having the phone in his face. Hi. Doesn't know what to make of it. So sometimes they don't like that. What's that thing? They also don't like when people are wearing masks. No, he's thinking, what's that thing in my face? He doesn't like the phone. Anyway, that's Mason. He's a sweet pup. So we're going to move them down into our puppy zone today, which is in the basement of my house. Ella said they untied her shoe. There they'll have a much bigger area to explore, and I also have like a dog door that leads out to an outside pen. There's another litter down there, currently Pepper. We were hoping to kind of put them all together. There is a bit of a size difference, so we'll have to see how that goes. But, you know, hopefully sometime this week they'll all be able to go outside in the pen together and get some exercise outside as well as inside. Someone's getting ready to have a pee, I think. This is what they do, they march around. They're on the hard kibble now, so their teeth are in. Mom is still nursing, but once they move downstairs, her access will be restricted so that she'll only be able to go in when I let her in, and then we'll get her weaned and ready to go home because she does not live with us. Those things in the water bowl are kibbles. We just have to change that. But they'll have a new water bowl when they go downstairs. So that is it for Luna and Caper's pups at 6 weeks.